Hi everyone, this is Anurag. In this session we are going to see the demo part of joints. So let us see the demo session. First of all, I want to connect to a normal user called as Oracle. Now here I have created a database name is test. So connect to the test database. Okay, then this is shortcut SQL plus slash SSDBA. SQL plus means there is a tool to connect to the database, whereas slash SSDBA means I want to log in as this user. Okay, give the command startup. Already database is started. I will clear the screen. Now I have created a user called u1. Okay, how to see the tables present in a user? Select star from tab. Okay, so in that there are several tables. Let us see the data present in employee table. Select star from EMP. It is showing some data. Select star from department. It is showing some data. Okay, if you see here, there are several employees and their details in employee table, but a column called D number is common in both tables. Okay, I want to see where this person Virat is working, and I want to see all the employee details where they are working. So I need to combine these two tables. There exists a direct relationship between two tables, that is D number column is same and all values are same. Okay, now we can perform a equi-join. How can we perform a equi-join? Select E number comma. Why we are performing equi-join? To combine the results of two tables. Okay, E number, E name, employee number comma D number, EMP comma D number comma D name comma location from employee comma department tables, where condition is employee dot D number equals to DEPT dot D number. This gives details about all the employees in which location they are working. Okay, this is called as equi-join. Okay, but this is not the condition what I want. I want to see where this person Virat is working. So I will give just E name, select E name comma location from employee comma department tables, where EMP dot D number equals to DEPT dot D number. Okay, what it is showing? It is showing all the details about the employees where they are working. I still want where to see that employee called Virat where he is working, and E name like I am giving Virat. Okay, it shows that Virat is working in Pune. Understood, right? This is equi-join. Now let us see something called as non-equi-join. Okay, select star from employee. What it is showing? It is showing the employee details. Okay, select star. I have created a table called as salgrade. One minute. Salgrade. So there are two tables, employee and salgrade. Now what I want is, I want to combine these two tables, but there is no same column, but there exists an indirect relationship between two tables. What is that relationship? In employee table we are having salary column, but in salgrade table we are having low sal and high sal. So I will combine these four tables based on this relationship, that is non-equi-join. Select E number comma E name comma salary comma grade from employee comma salgrade, where we are taking these values from employee comma salgrade tables. See, we will get output like this: E number, E name, salary, grade. Okay, where employee dot salary is greater than or equals to salgrade dot low sal, and EMP dot salary is less than or equals to salgrade dot high sal. Okay, it shows the output like this. Okay, we can see in which grade a employee falls. Okay, I want to get details about a particular employee, then we can use and. Okay, so this is one condition, and if you think this is tough to understand, there is one more way to retrieve the data. Select E number comma E name comma salary comma grade from employee comma department, sorry employee comma sal grade, where condition is employee dot d number, sorry, employee dot salary is between sal grade dot low sal and sal grade dot high sal. Okay, both the ways you can do. Okay, this is about non-equi join. Now let us see about left outer join. Okay, select star from employee. Okay, similarly select star from department. If you see here, I will add one more row into this department table, insert into DEPT values, and I am giving and 40 comma, since name is in characters we should give quotations, sales, and I am giving name as some Chennai. Okay, commit. Now select star from employee. 1 minute, I am cleaning the screen. Select star from employee. Select star from department. If you see, there is a row called as 40th row. 40th department is not present in employee table. That means extra information is present in department table and less information is present in employee table. So if I want to combine these two tables, okay, by using equi-join condition, it will show details about 10, 20 and 30th department only. I want to see details about 40th department also. So what we should do? Let us see. Select E number comma, E name comma, DEPT dot D number comma, D name comma, location from employee comma department table, where condition is important, where employee dot D number. Here employee dot D number, employee dot D number. Here employee table is having less information. So we should give a plus symbol on the table side which is having less information, equals to DEPT dot D number. Here department table is having extra information. Here you can see the 40th department also. Since we are taking D number values from department table, we are able to see this 40. If you take D number values from employee table, you cannot see this 40th department. Understood the concept? This is called left outer join. Why? Because we have given plus symbol on the left hand side. So by using left outer join, we have combined the two tables and we have retrieved the data. Now let us see right outer join. Okay, select star from employee. Okay, insert into EMP values. I am inserting 6 and name is some Kapil. And department is 40 and salary as some 15,000. Okay, commit. And from department table, okay, delete from department where D number equals to 40. Now see this. Select star from EMP, this is the data. Select star from DEPT, it is showing this data. If you see, department number 40 is present in employee table, whereas in department table there is no such department called as 40th department. So I want to combine these two tables. If you want to combine these two tables, employee and department, okay, by using equi-join, it will show details about 10, 20 and 30 department, but not 40th department. So I want to join these two tables by using right outer join. How? Let us see. Select E number comma, E name comma, EMP dot D number comma, D name comma, location from EMP dot, from EMP comma department, where EMP dot D number equals to DEPT dot D number. This is equijoint condition, but here less information is present in department table side. So give plus symbol on the table side which is having less information. So it shows data like this. Since we are taken D number values from EMP table, it is showing 40. Understood? Now this is about right outer join. Why? Because we have given plus symbol on the right hand side. Okay, this is right outer join. Now let us see the last topic in joins, that is self joins. Okay, here there is a table called as employee 1. Okay, it is showing details about few employees and their manager ID details. It is showing just manager ID. Here manager ID is nothing but employee number. That means manager ID 1 is nothing but employee number 1, that is Srinath. Srinath is manager of Rohit. Similarly, Rohit is manager of Raina. Okay, see, it is a bit confusing. Why? Because it is showing the manager ID but not showing the manager name. If we have manager name as the fourth column, then we can easily tell who is manager of whom. So for this purpose, I need to combine this table with itself. This is called as self join. The process, the join, the type of join in which we combine a table with itself is called a self join. Now let us see how to combine this table with itself. For this purpose, we are logically dividing this table as two tables, EMP1A and EMP1B. So let us see how to join. Select A dot E number, comma A dot E name, comma A dot manager ID, comma B dot E name from EMP1 space A, comma EMP1 space B, where condition we are giving is A dot manager ID equals to B dot E number. Since okay, manager ID is in number format, B number is also, E number is also in number format, then hence you can equate. Can we equate manager ID equals to E name? No. Why? Because their data types are different. Okay, now if you see here, employee number, E name, manager ID, E name, it is showing E name, E name. We cannot differentiate who is manager of whom. So I will rename this column as manager. Okay, so 1 minute, select, space should be given. So I'm clearing the screen, 1 minute. So let us see this. Select A dot E number, comma A dot E name, comma A dot manager ID, comma B dot E name. I'm renaming this column as manager. Okay, the thing, the problem here, previous one is I have given single quotations from EMP1 space A, comma EMP1 space B, where condition is important. A dot manager ID equals to B dot E number. Okay, like this it will show who is manager of whom. I want to see who is manager for employee name called Virat. So I use select E name, comma this one. It shows the employee name and manager name. I want to see and E name, A dot E name like Virat. It shows Virat manager is Srinath. Understood the concept, right? This is called self joins. Okay, this is about joins. Hope you enjoyed the session. Bye.